Hello and good morning, everyone. Welcome to my Floramancer world. As you can see, we still have no mana. But as I've explained numerous times, I do not AFK in my world. And the times that I have, we've had problems. So I'm sure if my world was stable enough to AFK, we may have some mana. But yeah, not as of yet. All right, I'm going to give you some updates on what's going on and show you the things that I have done before we get started. But I hope all of you are having a good weekend, ready for the next work week, whatever the plans may be. So right now, the last time we were playing, we found there was a chorus fruit problem. We weren't making enough chorus fruit to run the shulk me nots. These are still off. I'm still not running them because my chorus fruit farm is currently not running. And the reason the chorus fruit farm is not running, I brought it up with the mod pack maker just in case it's something to do with some imbalance in the pack, or gosh, I don't know. So let me explain something. In order to get chorus flowers to plant our chorus fruit farm, we need to use mana and the alchemy catalyst, right? And it uses 1/100th of a mana pool per flower, all right? Which means one mana pool will make 100 flowers. Okay, we've got that. I am not making enough mana and getting it over to this pool fast enough to keep up with flower demand. Part of it could be my infrastructure, and it's very, very likely it's my infrastructure, because we'll go over that in a second. The other part is, I've got all these other generating flowers running, and I'm still not able to keep up with keeping this mana pool full. Seems a little silly, because I'm only using 32 flowers each time I plant my farm. All right. So there's that challenge there. I keep coming over here and this mana pool is empty and there's popcorn fruit just floating on top in the mana pool. I've seen it numerous times, so I've just turned it off. It's off right now. This is building up its popcorn fruit supply, but like I said, the chorus fruit farm is currently turned off. So when that's out, that's done. Okay. So there's that part. I need to figure out how to make it mana positive to get the chorus flowers. There are two options I can see. One, set up a different mana pool pot for the cup force fruit setup that hopefully the mana pool stays full all of the time. Or just manually harvest a whole bunch of chorus flowers so I don't have to do this mana alchemy for the rest of the game. And that means doing like chests on chests of chorus flowers. It's doable. It does mean I would have to set up a chorus flower farm and just go to town. Do arrows work on the flower? Not in 1.12. That was added in 1.14, Falkandav. That was something that was added in 1.14 Minecraft. The boar lens does not work on the flowers. The iron rod from Quark does not work on the flowers. Those are things that I checked. It has to be broken by a player in 1.12. So, yeah. That's where we're at with that. I did expand the chorus fruit farm because I was running out of chorus fruit as well. I think I remember you guys from last time seeing that I was running out of chorus fruit to make the cocoons turn into shulkers. So what I've done over here, I've made it larger, added these little wings here that have actually added another 16, I believe. spots. So we've got that. I could make it even bigger if we can do enough chorus fruit. But again, that's where our problem is. So this is currently not producing any chorus. Currently. I started digging out a space here for me to set up just a chorus flower farm. And we may end up doing that. I can't move this block because it exposes the mana line that I have here. So I'll need to move it over a tiny bit. But yeah, we'll probably clear this spot out, set up a long line of chorus flower farming, and I'll just have to spend a long time collecting a bunch of flowers so I don't have to use mana to convert them into flowers, because that's a problem. All right, so that's where we are there. Hi, Nisi. Nice to see you. Good morning. Let me check my wheat real quick. Yeah, we're running really low on wheat. I'm gonna have to fix that too. Ugh. Okay, so let me show you the infrastructure problem that we've got going on with why that mana pool is just not staying full. And it's just the way I have everything set up. So let's go into spectator mode. This is the mana line that fuels the crafting. There we go. This is that mana line. And as you can see here, these mana pools are, for the most part, empty. I'm just not getting enough mana in my array into this line. So I have that as a problem. We're just not producing enough mana to fill these up, to keep them full, so that when it gets over here to this mana pool, which is the one that fuels the chorus fruit, it's just, it can't. Yeah, so there's my problem. Yeah, this is just always empty, so it can never fill this one, which can't fill this one. It's just a circle. So that's what I've got to figure out what to do here. So what I have done to try and help that, and I mean try and help that. I didn't know I had some lava patches in here. Okay. One of the things I have done to try and help that is expand the hydrangeas. This is underneath the ground. This is what you've been constantly seeing forever. I went underground. The distance that the Ren and Carpus can reach is how far I went. So I have two layers of more hydrangeas. That's as far as the Ren and Carpus can reach. Then I've got the mana spreaders with phantom lenses pointing to the mana spreader right there that connects to the system. So, yes, this is 100 hydrangeas, I believe, in total. I know this is the worst flower, but I was like, I was trying to figure out where I could expand flowers without increasing the need for supplies. Hydrangeas was one of those. The other one that I've also done, which I know I'm in spectator mode, I have added 4 more endoflames. We are we do have a balance issue. I think we're holding right at steady at 306 stacks. We're holding steady there. So I think we're at a neutral for supply here. Okay. So I added the 2 here and then the 2 on the other side here next to that living wood block. And again, remember, we do have the few that are under here as well. All right, my next plan, hopefully, I haven't done it yet, is I can expand the thermalilies, because this is just supplies being provided unlimited from the nether. All right, I will need to move my Ren and Carpus back closer to the portal because of the range, but I could knock out these sections here and put more flowers that way on both sides, here and here. and expand the Thermalily setup. I haven't done that yet, clearly, but this is another one where I can expand to get more mana. I also changed this mana spreader over to the Elven instead of the regular one. I'm going to turn it back to the regular one now because we're running low on wheat. And, you know, this needs 3 wheat every single time it needs a cake. So we're going to switch this back, but I did have it as the Elven for a time. So we have that. And then this one in the timers for the dropping of the flowers, I reduced it by a couple of seconds. Each one of these has been reduced by a couple of seconds, so it goes a little faster. So yeah, this one goes just a little faster to produce a little bit more. So I've done some boosting as much as I can on the mana, the flowers that I can do. Can't increase this one without making another tree farm. And I think that is it. My Gormerless I left alone. So yeah, down here I've had some problems with supply in the hall here, specifically with fell pumpkins. It is such a balancing act. And fishing rods. The reason I had a problem with fishing rods is that the fell pumpkins need place cards. They need these, and it had stopped functioning, so it used them all up, and so then the fishing rods didn't have any of the place cards to call for its empty spots, so then it broke that. The Spectralis, oh yes, the Spectralis is doing all right. I bred some more sheep. I went in here and checked all the chests. It's not currently running. Which one is it out of? Brown. I'll need to breed some more brown sheep. I've just been breeding sheep whenever it's been running out of wool. It's currently too low on brown, but yeah, so it's been doing okay. Can I speed this one up? I need more wool because not all of these are very full. Like, see, I'm gonna need more blue and more light gray. It's just, there's very specific colors that I'm really low on compared to others. That, yeah, I just need more sheep. Need more sheep. So that's one I can't speed up any further. And this I totally can't speed up because I just don't have the gunpowder. So there's that. There's what we're doing here. That's, it's kind of weird that I've got all of these things running and I'm still running out of mana. Now, with that said, it's very, very possible that there was a cascading issue that consumed all of our mana before I noticed it was consuming the mana, and I've fixed the problem and I just haven't rebuilt my mana buffer. Very possible. So I do need to breed some more sheep, and we can go ahead and take care of that. And then figure out the coarse fruit. Get the coarse fruit fixed. The other thing that I've done, and I'm staying in spectator mode because it goes in walls and stuff. If you remember correctly, a while ago, I had a mana line set up going from our pools, our battery, to the back of this. I took it out. Right here. It was right here. I took it out, which took a long time because I had mana tablets so I could pick up the mana in the pools and move it back over to the battery. Because I don't need mana coming from here and going to these mana pools. What I'm going to do is take the mana from the Dandelion and send it that way. And so it'll go past these and it'll fill these first. So any excess from these will get sent to the battery. I also moved most of. I need to move the pool from there yet, but and put a dominant on there, don't I? Oh no, because this is a recessive, isn't it? Maybe not. So we need to do that. It's not pulling the mana out of this one because I thought it was a recessive, and instead it's a dominant over here. So I need to take care of this one, get it taken out, move it over here, because that way all the mana pools are in one line. They're all of these taking for the things for to run this. So this is currently not running because of that. Okay. So I haven't done anything over here. There's nothing new here. I did place the mana spreader. I don't have it pointing up into the mana pool yet. And then I have the other mana pool here to try to begin sending it that direction. So that's what we've got going on right now. And it is quite the balancing act. Make sure these are all okay. And then let's go make sure the flowers are all okay. Woof. Nope. Yes. Yes, those all look okay. All right. So far, those are all right. So, yeah. There's where we are. Up, 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 up. That's what's going on right now. So... I don't know why spectator mode seems to use my flugel tiara. I'm not sure on that. Alright, so with all of that in mind, we have a few things to do today. We have chorus flowers. We need to make that farm. We need more sheep. And for that, we needed brown, white. Oh, I forgot. I think I need cyan. Wheat. We need to address that issue. And we need to decide whether or not we're going to expand the thermalilies. Because that's technically a free resource into mana option. All right, let's do the breeding first. I need to go get some wheat. Let's do, and then we also need, let's see, we want brown. Let's do 2 cocoa beans, and we'll get white, and then I need to look and see what other ones we need to do. Okay. Light blue wouldn't go amiss. Cyan. Light gray. All right. Two mystical cyan petals. 2 mystical light gray petals. Looks like I had dye in there. Okay. All right, let's go do this. Hello, guys. Goodness. I have some more in here. I was just seeing how quickly it's harvesting things. We have some space over here, so let's breed. I have no clue what colors these guys are. And I don't think you can color baby sheep, can you? Oh, you can. Oh, good. Okay. All right. Let's go this way. Where is my baby sheep? There it is. Oh, but it's a, oh, yellow. There we go. Yellow is now brown. And then we'll just breed a couple more here. There we go. All right. Got more sheep going. Yay. We'll see how that does. I may need to increase the frequency of this. Because every time it harvests, it can only do 32 max at a time. I believe it's 32, might be 16. And so it's leaving some of them unharvested each time. And that might be an issue. Okay. Oh, wait, I've got a wool on me. So, we'll see if that helps after a bit. Let's grab a regular mana spreader and slow down the cake flower. Oh, where did I put... I have no clue where I put it. There it is. A regular mana spreader. Because we're going to run out of wheat if I let this keep running. Alright. So that'll slow that down quite a bit. And we'll put you in here. Yeah, the wheat, actually, it's not necessarily a problem. It's just that it's not large enough. It's not producing enough wheat. It's the same problem it's always had. That bottom layer doesn't get planted as consistently, as you can see. And it's just this bottom layer. The other layers plant just fine. So, I can't go up any further without moving a mana pool from that mana line up, because this is as far as it can reach. So, in order to make it taller, I'll need to move a mana pool up. But I could make another wheat farm like this, probably skinnier, and go here with it, and go that way, and just have one row here and one row here. Same redstone for all the layers, yep. It's the same redstone all the way around. Every layer is exactly the same. So, yep. I have a nano farm, sort of. It's not automatic. It's not, it's an automatic farm. It's one I have to, I do not have a bone meal supply, no. Because I can't keep my mob farm running over there. Without AFKing over at my mob farm. So it's my nano farm. When I do have bone meal, which I might have some in there now. It's not super consistent. Because of my tick lag that I've got going on. I don't know if you can tell that my game is running a lot slower, a lot staggery, jumpy. So, there you go. Now you can tell it is. Give me a seed. I didn't get a single seed back. What? And that's just louder than loud, too. Maybe I need to stand to the side. So it gave me a whole 39 wheat with all that noise. Anyway, yeah, with all the frames and sparks that it needs, it is a laggier when you're trying to do this. So I am awfully glad that I'm almost done with everything, but I still have a ways to go. Something I need to check. How am I at Ender Air? Okay, I'm okay at Ender Air. I am out of mana pearls. We're not out, but I'm getting low. I don't have any actual Ender pearls, and that's all the mana pearls I have. And I'm starting to run low on I'm running low on diamonds because I can't run my miner. So those things are running low. Yeah, I'm just reaching a lot of challenges in getting these so that I can actually say, hey, everything's automated, the pack's done. What do you think will be next? What do you mean, infinite? Do I have any endstone? Yep, okay. The next step is a coarse fruit, or coarse flower farm. Oh, after I'm done with this pack, what's next, essentially? Well, I know I would like to do a vanilla playthrough because there's so many new different things. Yeah, I'm probably going to expand the thermalilies, but I would like to get the coarse flowers growing while I can do that. So I need to set this up so I can do that. Okay, I do one here and here. Is that what I want to do? Have them there and there. If I have it three, if I have it to here, I could put one in the middle here. Trying to figure out where to put the um One there. One there. I think I should be able to do that. All right, so if we do that size, and then the two here needs to be where we have that. Oops. Like that around each one. Mm-hmm. And so on and so forth. Whoops. There's five, almost. All right, and so then we can just replicate that a certain distance. This way. And it's three, one, two, three, one, two, three. We'll have to move that way a little bit further. And then in the middle, whoops. Okay. There's the start of a little coarse fruit farm. Hi, Darkwing. Okay, let's go get the flowers. And that'll be a start. I probably will make it longer eventually, but I just want to get some going. All right. All right. So we have this ready to go. And this should provide us a decent number of flowers because the way this is set up, I'll get at least two, hopefully, from each one that grows. Hopefully. And let's, let's just tuck these in here. The next time this water runs, it'll request those flowers and it'll run this once. So see, this has got three. Yeah, this one grew three. So my hope is that it'll grow a decent number of them that I can just run down and collect all the ones off of here and then get the bottom stems and just go from there. All right. Really considering tackling that wheat farm next. Really, really trying to figure that one out. Let's go look at it again. All right, so we have a mana pool back here without a spark on it. The problem is if I were to put one up higher with a spark, it'd have to be a dominant spark, which wouldn't push mana to the middle section in order to make this taller. I'd have to do an even further one up. Okay. I need a whole mess of supplies to make this go up further. It should be harvesting pretty soon. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm going to do this between streams. I think I'll work on it this afternoon or this evening. I'm going to make it taller. Because why not? We need to like almost double the amount of wheat we're producing. I'm going to probably just do two more layers of this and see how that does. Let's see. So we've got the chorus flowers. Let's go over here. Higher mana production. I could do another two set up like that. Or I bet I could do another one of these. Let's see here. All right, so that's up piece I can't move. How wide is this section? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Take care, Fokendob. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I could do it, I think. How far do you reach? This way. Nope. I can't. They will only go to there. Was that the same on this side? Pretty much. So I need to stay within that width. Because this flower is just going to get moved back. Probably to in this middle section here. So move it back a couple. That's as far as it goes. If I move it back a couple, it goes here. How far does it reach here? Okay. So I could add another 4. 2 on this side and 2 on that side. Thermalilies. Pretty sure I can do that. I will definitely need to make more buckets. Yep. All right, let's grab our redstone box. Let's see what supplies we have. We need dispensers, which we have droppers. We can turn those. We need some open crates. Sticky pistons. We have redstone, mana pools. We have one elven spreader, so we'll be able to do 2, and then I'll have to grab another elven spreader. Let's make the dispensers. 6 string and 6 sticks. I'm going to say dispensers. Do we have item frames in here? We do not. So we need to do stack sticks and 8 leather. Okay, let's try this again. There we go. So we have those. I need living wood to make the open crates. I need sticky pistons, which I think I have regular pistons. Do I need more than one sticky piston? I think so. Two sticky pistons, and we need redstone. How much do we have in there? Okay, we have enough redstone. We need hoppers. I need to make hoppers. Let's get rid of some of the stone I'm hanging on to. Get rid of you two. Okay. Hang on. For birch wood and 10 iron. ingots. Oof, we don't have a whole lot of iron, do we? So there's that. And we'll pick you up. Grab some of you and get started. Okay, so we're gonna use regular dirt for where the flower is gonna go. Well, actually use limestone where I'm gonna put the flowers for now, and then we'll replace it with coarse dirt just so I can plan this out. The flowers could go here and here. Which means the open crates go here to drop the buckets. And on the back of those will be hoppers. And the dispensers on top. Okay, and then in the middle, behind each dispenser, is a piston. It's going to have a redstone block on top. One. And that's to keep the hoppers locked. Okay. And then we need you on top of the pistons, like so. We could put one in the middle so we don't see that stuff. And that's where the timer goes with the redstone. Like that. All right. Is that it? We need access to that. We need to put item frames on the inside here. That'll be for the lava buckets. I'm going to need to fill this up with cobble or something, except for the one spot. Then I need to make a bunch of empty buckets. And I need to grab a hopper hawk and a timer. And where am I going to put wonder if this is within range. If I put this one here, can it reach? It looks like it can reach the one down there. And that'll be the one I shoot into for that one. All right. Let's go grab a hopper hawk and some handfuls of cobble and buckets. So we need hopper hawk. I need iron ingots. We'll do 16 for now. Let's make the hopperhock a floaty variety. Then we need a bunch of cobblestone. Hi, Warlord! Nice to see you! I'm actually gonna need these to be buckets too. So much stuff in my inventory I need to deal with. Put you away. Alright. Let's go figure this out. I took an IRL break. I've had a pretty crummy summer, so I've not been around. So, you probably didn't miss a whole lot, because there hasn't been a whole lot to miss. Okay. To get those going, to get filled up, and so now I just need thermalilies. Let's make some coarse dirt. Thermalilies and the timer, right? Remember how much sand. I think it's 6 minutes. We'll grab one extra just in case I am wrong, because I could be wrong. And then coarse dirt. I think we have some. There's that. So we need, can we, this guy reach those two spots? Yes, we won't need to move it. Can reach those two spots. So we just need to, what's the timer? 5 minutes. You make it. One, there's 12. That would explain the 5 minutes. I need 14, 16 eventually. That's 3.75 minutes, so if I make it 4 for now. There we go. It'll get caught up. And then these are, yep, 5 minutes. So we'll wait to run that until we actually have flowers there. And lava, of course. Which that should be coming back shortly.